एक प्रश्न आज जो मेरे सामने है वो है हीलिंग से रिलेटेड. यू नो आई बीन डूइंग हीलिंग एंड दिस इज वेरी रिलेवेंट फॉर टुडे बिकॉज नेक्स्ट दिस वीकेंड वी हैव रेकी वर्कशॉप, रेकी लेवल 1 and 2. सो हीलिंग से रिलेटेड एक सवाल है और दिस क्वेश्चन मेनी पीपल हैव बीन आस्किंग मी फ्रॉम लॉन्ग टाइम. द क्वेश्चन इज डू वी वेन वी डू द हीलिंग Do we take others' karma, you know, or is healing a kind of meddling with other person's energy? And there is a great master from South. He always say that you are not supposed to heal anybody. Anyway, with all the due respect to all the masters, before I answer this question, I want to know from you how many of you have this question. Those who are into healing field or those who have learned healing, do you think that or do you have this question that you know if we do healing for others, जब हम दूसरों की healing करते हैं तो क्या उनके कर्म हम ले लेते हैं? कितने लोगों के मन में ये सवाल है आप मुझे बताइए, जो healing कर रहे हैं, जो regularly healing कर रहे हैं या जो healing सीखना चाहते हैं, जिन्होंने रेकी के बारे में, hypnotherapy के बारे में, you know all the other healing modalities जितनी भी आपने सीखी है, कितने लोगों को यह सवाल है कि क्या हम दूसरों की जब हीलिंग करते हैं तो क्या उनके कर्म हम ले लेते हैं? यू कैन जस्ट पुट योर कमेंट्स इन द चैट बॉक्स. ओके, दीपमाला जैन बोलती है नो. ठीक है, आई हैव दिस क्वेश्चन. ओके, कमला जी हैज दिस क्वेश्चन. फाइन, एंड आई एम श्योर मोस्ट ऑफ दोज यू नो हु आर इन टू द हीलिंग फील्ड और दोज हु आर डूइंग द हीलिंग, वंस इन अ वाइल वी गेट दिस क्वेश्चन, यू नो, कि whether by healing others do we take others' karmas or is it that we are disturbing other person's energy. Yes, Asha is saying that we are not taking others' karma, and yes. So the question is, when we do the healing, जब हम healing करते हैं तो क्या हम उस व्यक्ति के कर्म हम खुद ले लेते हैं? या इज दिस हीलिंग अ काइंड ऑफ मेडलिंग विद द अदर पर्सन्स एनर्जी? एंड आई बीइंग अ हीलर, बीइंग अ थेरेपिस्ट, बीइंग अ मेंटर, टीचर ऑफ हीलिंग, अ ग्रैंड मास्टर ऑफ रेकी, हैव बीन हीलिंग फ्रॉम पास्ट मोर देन 12 इयर्स एंड आई हैव टेकन मोर देन 3000 1-on-1 सेशंस. आई हैव हील्ड मेनी पीपल्स अक्रॉस द ग्लोब, आई कैन से नाउ, एंड आई कैन authoritatively say that healing is not at all meddling with the other person's energy. By doing healing, we are not taking anybody's karma at all. Healing karke, and I'll give you the a proper answer for this. Don't worry. Healing karne se hum dusro ke karma nahi lete hain. Nahi, healing karne se hum dusro ki energy ko disturbance kar rahe hain. Jo log ye baat bolte hain, मुझे नहीं पता कि उनको हीलिंग के बारे में कुछ भी पता है या नहीं. आई रियली डू नॉट नो द पर्सन हु सेज दैट यू आर नॉट सपोज टू डू हीलिंग फॉर अदर्स. इट इज माई ओपिनियन और इट इज माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट दैट पर्सन डज नॉट हैव द इनडेप्थ नॉलेज ऑफ हीलिंग साइंस. बिकॉज टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्वेश्चन और टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वी आर नॉट यू नो meddling with the other person energy, we need to understand what is healing first. So the first point we need to understand, what is healing? Say for example, you have some problem in your neck, you come to me and I teach you some head exercise, you know, up and down, and that heals your neck pain. Now I am teaching you just a yoga exercise, a simple yoga exercise which is healing your neck pain. That is a healing. Do you think the person who is teaching you yoga is doing something wrong? If you come to me with any problem and if I teach you some kind of, you know, pranayama, some kind of meditation or anything else, what does it going to do in your life? It is going to heal your problem ultimately, right? Right or wrong? Theek hai na? Jo bhi main aapko sikhaunga, chahe wo yoga ho, chahe wo pranayama ho, chahe wo meditation ho, उससे आपकी लाइफ में कुछ बेहतरी ही आएगी. योर लाइफ इज गोइंग टू बिकम लिटिल ईज, लिटिल सोलेस यू आर गोइंग टू गेट. यू आर गोइंग टू गेट हील्ड बाय प्रैक्टिसिंग दैट. दैट मींस इफ आई एम टीचिंग यू योगा, इफ आई एम टीचिंग यू प्राणायाम, इफ आई एम टीचिंग यू मेडिटेशन और एनी अदर थिंग लाइक दैट, इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ हीलिंग. द ओनली डिफरेंस दैट आई एम नॉट यूजिंग द वर्ड हीलिंग. Even the simple counseling what we do is a kind of healing, right? And counseling can be done by a friend, by mentor, by parents, by guru, anybody. And if I am doing, say for example, if you are disturbed, mentally disturbed by something in your life, you come to me and I do your counseling. I make you understand that this problem is nothing. You can relax like this, you can relax like that and this. And if it gives you that little solace, if it is making you a little easier, right? From disease, it is taking you towards the ease of your life. That is healing. The simple counseling is also a part of healing, right? So what is the definition of healing? The simple definition of healing is, you are helping other person to send that problem, whatever that person has, it has come from somewhere. It has some root, it has some, you know, source. And, you know, helping a person to send that problem back to its source is healing. एक व्यक्ति आपके पास आता है, उसको कुछ प्रॉब्लम है और वो प्रॉब्लम कहीं ना कहीं से आई है, चाहे उसके पास से हो, चाहे उसके कर्मा से हो, चाहे कहीं से भी हो, उस प्रॉब्लम को वापस उसके सोर्स तक पहुंचाने की जो प्रक्रिया हम करते हैं, जो सिखाते हैं उसको या जो बताते हैं उसको, जो गाइड करते हैं उसको, वो हीलिंग है. इन दैट सेंस ऑल द योगा, प्राणायाम, मेडिटेशन, ऑल द स्पिरिचुअल टेक्निक्स, स्पिरिचुअल यू नो प्रैक्टिसेस, व्हाटएवर यू आर डूइंग, दे आर ऑल पार्ट ऑफ द हीलिंग. द ओनली डिफरेंस इज देयर वी आर नॉट यूजिंग द वर्ड हीलिंग, बट द वर्क इट डज इज द सेम. It does the work of healing. Therefore, whatever a master teaches, even that master who says that healing is wrong, he is also teaching some techniques to the people, and those techniques are also making the people's life little easier, right? Otherwise, nobody will come and learn. If I teach you some meditation which is going to create a hell in your life, will you come and learn that meditation technique? You'll never. So whatever we are teaching, any master or any guru teaching, it is bringing a sign of some kind of ease in their life, and bringing ease in their life is a kind of healing, right? So healing, all these things are healing, the first thing. Second, when you come to healing, learning healing, we clearly and very first and basic principle of healing is, you are not meddling with the other person's energy at all. You are not supposed to meddle with the other person's energy. We are not doing that. In healing, we call the healer as a channel. We are not healers. Because, you know, outside world, those who do not know what is channel, we tell that we are the healer. But in healing, when you learn the healing, the very first principle we teach you is, we are not the healers. We are the channel, so that energy, the divine energy, which wants to work through us. Therefore, we are not giving our energy at all. Neither we are taking anybody's energy at all in the healing. How this happens? People come to me from various parts of the world, in fact, not only the India, but various parts of the world people come to me. And most of the people, I do not know them, they do not know me. They just get some connection from somewhere. Somebody, you know, tells about me something, and that person, you know, search about me on the internet or through some friend or some known person, and they contact me for their healing. When they contact me, they come to me, I do the healing, they seek for healing, they are asking for healing, and I am giving them the healing. And in healing, we clearly say that unless and until the other person is not asking for the healing, you are not supposed to heal them. करेक्ट, सो दैट पर्सन इज सीकिंग हीलिंग फ्रॉम मी, सो हाउ डज दैट पर्सन गेट कनेक्टेड टू मी, आई कॉल दैट अ यूनिवर्सल नेटवर्क, बिकॉज सम पर्सन हु हैज गिवन माय रेफरेंस टू दैट पर्सन हैज बिकम द निमित्त, द मींस टू कनेक्ट दैट पर्सन विथ मी थ्रू सम डिवाइन अनसीन कनेक्शंस. इन भगवद गीता कृष्ण क्लियरली सेज निमित्त मात्र भव अर्जुन. यू नो व्हेन अर्जुन सेज दैट हाउ कैन आई किल ऑल दीज पीपल एंड कृष्ण सेज यू आर नॉट किलिंग देम, यू आर जस्ट बिकमिंग निमित्त टू किल देम, आई हैव ऑलरेडी किल्ड देम. सो दीज पीपल हु गिव माई रेफरेंस और एनीबडी एनी हीलर्स रेफरेंस टू एनीबडी, दे आर जस्ट बिकमिंग दैट निमित्त फॉर दैट डिवाइन वर्क, that divine energy which wants to connect that person with me. And then in healing, when we do the healing, we just teach a person to tap into that source from where this whole energy, this whole prana is coming. And we are taking energy from that source, and as a channel, we just become the channel for that divine energy, and that divine force wants to work through us. That divine force, that divine energy wants to heal that person through you. As a healer, you are becoming just channel for that energy. You are not healing. We are not giving our energy at all. We are just taking the energy from the higher self or higher source. That energy is flowing through you, and that energy is healing that person. Therefore, we are just a mediator or a channel for that energy, that divine energy. You know, energy which wants to work through us, right? So we are just the channel for that energy. Now that divine energy, you may ask, why, how do you say that that divine energy wants to work through you? For that divine energy to work on this physical plane, it needs some physical means. Right. The third point here is just go back in the time. We all have heard about Ramayana, and to kill Ravana, Vishnu had to take the birth as Rama. Now question comes, Vishnu could have killed, you know, directly from there to Ravana, no? Why he has to take birth as Rama, small baby, and then grow up, and then he has to kidnap the Sita, and all those things has to happen. He could have directly, you know, baan wahan se chhod sakta tha. Jahan par bhi Vishnu baithe hain, wahan se baan chhod ke Ravana ko maar sakte the. Itna sab natak karne ki kya zarurat thi? We need to understand here is, Vishnu is that energy. It is not physical manifestation. In my second question, when I'll go through the second question today, for today, I'll explain what that Vishnu is, what that energy is. So that higher energy, when it has to work on the physical plan, it has to take the birth as a physical person. जब higher energy या भगवान जिसे हम कहते हैं, उसे physical plan में अगर कुछ भी करना है, तो उसको human birth लेना जरूरी है. Human form में आएगा तभी वो रावण को मार सकता है, नहीं तो वो रावण को डायरेक्टली नहीं मार सकता, क्योंकि डिवाइन एनर्जी कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली वर्क ऑन द फिजिकल प्लान. इट हैज टू हैव सम मींस ऑफ फिजिकल मैनिफेस्टेशन, दैट इज फिजिकल बॉडी, एंड दैट इज व्हाई विष्णु टेक्स द बर्थ अवतार ऑफ रामा एंड ही किल्स रावण. द सेम वे विष्णु कुड हैव डायरेक्टली किल्ड द कंस, व्हाई ही हैड टू टेक द बर्थ एज कृष्णा? डजंट दिस क्वेश्चन कम्स, नो, व्हाई ऑल दिस आकाशवाणी, एंड आफ्टर डूइंग आकाशवाणी इज, यू नो, उनके माता पिता को जेल में डाल दिया गया आकाशवाणी की वजह से, चुप भी तो बैठ सकते थे. ऑल दैट हैज कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस, ऑल दैट हैज, यू नो, अ सॉलिड रीजन फॉर इट, बिकॉज विष्णु कुड नॉट डायरेक्टली किल द कंसा, बिकॉज दैट एनर्जी कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली वर्क ऑन द फिजिकल प्लान, इट टेक्स द मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ अ फिजिकल बॉडी, दैट इज कृष्णा, ही कम्स एज अ कृष्णा एंड किल्स द कंसा. So, for that higher divine energy to work on the physical plane, it needs some physical manifestation, it needs some physical body, it needs some physical channel through which it can work. And that is why that divine energy uses this body to heal that person, because that divine energy wants to heal that person through you, not through, you know, not from me, but through me. And that is why, and in healing, I have been always saying that unless and until you do not completely surrender to that Almighty, you cannot become the great healer. To become a great healer, you have to dissolve yourself into that higher energy, or you just have to allow that higher energy to work through you. And when you allow completely that higher energy to work through you, you do not exist that there at all. And when you do not exist, जब आप वहां पर है ही नहीं, तो आप कर्म लेने के या कर्म देने के लिए बाध्य नहीं होते हैं. आप ना तो कर्म देते हैं, नहीं आप कर्म लेते हैं, नहीं आप कर्म कुछ कर रहे हैं. You just become the means for that divine energy to work through you and heal that person who is coming for the healing to you. And therefore, I can authoritatively and clearly say that healing, by healing, you are not taking anybody's karma, nor healing is meddling with other person's energy at all. Clear?